What is up guys, today I'll be showing you how to do a multiple overhand sliding lanyard. This one is made of paracord. As you know, paracord has many uses and it's very strong. At the same time, it's very comfortable, so it's great for making lanyards. This lanyard can be used in a regular lanyard hole, like the one in this saw, just by inserting the two ends on the hole. Feed everything through the lanyard, through the hole, sorry guys, and that's it. There's your lanyard on your saw. The advantage of this lanyard, it actually has another way to use it. Imagine you have a situation like this. You have a lot of slack in here. This lanyard can be tightened, just like this. And you already have your lanyard adjusted in a comfortable way for you. Done, that's it, very simple guys. Took me what, 1 second to do this. Other great thing about this lanyard, it can be deployed. When I mean deployed, means you can unwrap it in around 2 seconds. Just like this. That's it. Now you have 3 feet of paracord ready to use. To do this project, you need paracord. Paracord comes in many different colors, thicknesses, and it's very comfortable and has hundreds of uses. So paracord is definitely a great choice for a lanyard. Rescue Orange, Gecko, Blue Camo, Urban Camo. It's just an example of colors that you can find in paracord. Of course, you can do this using other types of cordage. It's up to you. Personally, I prefer paracord. You also will need a ruler. Ruler sometimes helps in measuring. Make sure you have the length that you really want. If you want to do something really precise or not waste paracord, because paracord sometimes can be a bit expensive. It depends what type of paracord you are getting. A knife or a scissors always helps. Personally, I like the Swiss Army scissors because they are very, very sharp and make those precise cuts where I want to, making the lanyard look good. But of course, a knife is also very useful, but it's not as useful as a scissors. Swiss Army knife has both, so just choose. Of course, regular knives like this one can be used, but as you can see, it will make regular cuts. It will make your lanyard look as good as you want to. To make this lanyard, you will need around 3 feet of paracord. Grab one end. This end will tell you how long your lanyard will be. So, this will be the length of your lanyard. I like it like this. Next, grab the longest end. Go up at least 1 inch. Or 1.5 should be a little bit better. The longer end, grab it and make turns like this in your direction and upwards, like this. Just don't forget you need to go upwards. I'm going to do it again for you guys to see. Longer end goes to you, around everything and upwards. This is overhand knot. By keep doing this, this is a multiple overhand knot. 1, 2, at least 10 guys. I did 11. Now grab your lanyard like this. Now we need to grab the longer end and go under all of these loops that we made. To do this, grab the first one, the longer one. Hold it with your fingers and just go through all of the loops like this. Don't worry about how it will look, because in the end we'll end up tightening everything. So don't worry about how it looks like. By tightening just the first loop a bit, it'll prevent it sliding off. So let's keep doing this under all of the loops. As you can see, already wants to slide off, just tighten it a little bit. The longer line went through inside all of the loops that we made, so we are starting to look like a decent lanyard. And to finish it, just tied it. As you can see, the last one got tighter, but other ones are loose. To fix this, just rotate your lanyard like this, twist it. As you can see, everything is getting tighter. Then the longer one, pull it again a little bit. Looks much, much better. And one more time just to finish. As you can see, the loose line right there. And that's it. Looks okay right now. And just to finish it, personally, I like it really, really tight. Just like this. To finish, we grab our knife or scissors. In this case, I prefer the scissors. Trim the ends. Just like this, the way you like it. Grab a lighter, burn the ends. Once it's melting, use the metal part to flatten them out. Or if your hands are a bit harder, you can easily do it your fingers without burning yourself. And that's it, here's our lanyard. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you do, please give me a thumbs up. It always helps my channel, or even favorite this video if you want to try this project later. Thank you guys for all the support. I already reached around 6,000 subs. I really appreciate everyone's support, everyone's views. Thank you guys. I'll be back as soon as I can with another video. Take care guys. Have a great day.